The hardy-weinberg theorem is something that's really commonly questioned and commonly asked on tests and these kind of things, and sometimes it can be a little bit confusing. But you know, I'll try to make it as simple as possible. The most important thing to understand in the hardy-weinberg theorem is that this really describes a population that's not evolving. That you know, the alleles aren't changing, you know, from generation to the next. Like there's no evolution, or at least microevolution. And in order for this to be maintained, there have to be different, you know, conditions that have to be met. And normally they say these five conditions need to be met. And these conditions, actually what I have listed here, these five are actually deviations from Hardy-Weinberg. But obviously, you know, the ones that you need, you just put no in front of it. So my mnemonic is Mother Mary does not smoke. The M will stand for mutations, migration, you know, and then the rest stand for genetic drift, D, you know, does drift, non-random mating and natural selection. So these are deviations of Hardy-Weinberg. Mutations. In order for Hardy-Weinberg theorem to be accurate, there have to be no mutations. There have to be no changes in, like, sudden changes in alleles or these kind of things. There also have to be, you know, there doesn't have to be any migration either, you know. There can't be any gene flow. These populations have to be isolated. Genetic drift, you know, the population size has to be, you know, pretty large. You know, it can't be like 10 people or something. The mating has to be random. And there has to be no natural selection as well. Now, to get into the actual concept of the actual equation, we use this equation here, p squared plus 2pq plus q squared equals 1, where p plus q equals 1. Now, this looks a little bit confusing, but it's actually not too bad. The p represents the dominant allele, or in other words, you know, what you normally see is like a big capital P, and then you'll see like a lowercase p, right? So the p here represents this p, and then the q represents this p, like the smaller one. The q represents the recessive allele. So the middle one here, the 2pq, this represents the heterozygous state. And so that would represent like a p, and then like a p, little p. Whereas the p squared would be a two capital p's, and then the pq cubed would be the lower q's, would be the lower q's, or the recessive alleles. And these will both add up to 1.